dear Zerky is known for being a calm and peace-loving individual, committed to serving anyone and everyone. But what most patrons do not realize is that our family used to be elite synthoid weapons. Zerky himself conducted whole symphonies of pain, crushing his foes with ease. But as he sat amidst the ruins of Scar Stew, pondering the mass extinction he brought upon its people, he realized that he could kill anything except hunger and thirst. So he laid down his blaster and built a place where he could try to slay those feelings on a daily basis. Ooh, so inspiring! Ms. Zircon, on the other hand, built a tidy side business selling and modifying weapons for those still hungry for violence, while their beloved son, Junior, set up a battle arena for those still thirsty for pain.
Here we are again, buddy. We just can't stop landing in tight spots, huh?
It would appear so. But there is no one else I would rather be in such a dire situation with.
Rivet! Oh, thank you again for rescuing me. Glad I can be a part of this little travel-rousing group. Such a wide people here, and in such good spirits. I'd hardly know the dimensions were in jeopardy.
Do not forget your weapons. You will need them to kick the Emperor's patootie.
Good thing we're ending this now. I don't think the dimensions can take much more.
The ultimate weapon is here! And it is all thanks to you, honey!
The Rhino! The greatest instrument of mayhem this universe will ever know!
Until the next one gets me.
Just pull the fire trigger to rip open a hole to another dimension. What will come out? Little Zircon is not telling.
Little Zircon doesn't really know.
Ooh-wee! That one is so, oh, hot right now.
This one. Hi, Jim.
Thank you.